Hi, everybody. It's Dr. Lori. This is Ask Dr. Lori Live. Everything's unscripted. I don't know what's coming. I'm going to show you how to tell so you can make good decisions at the thrift store, the yard sale, the antique mall, or you can build good collections for yourself or resell it. All right. My guests are here from all over the world. Thanks to all of them for participating and for you for watching and sharing, too. Let's see what we've got. Pick up those pieces. Let's see. Let's see the blue glass. Big, huge, tall, blue glass piece. What is that? Hello.
Hi, this is Angela from Phoenix, Arizona.
Hi, Angela. How are you? Look at your pretty red hair.
Oh, thank you.
So much. Nice to see you. So what have you got there, hun?
This is a Fenton hobnail swung glass vase. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to find it in the actual catalog yet. I've been hunting, but haven't found it in the catalog yet. But okay. I got it about a month
ago. Wait. Well, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but let me interrupt you.
I'm sorry.
So, first of all, you couldn't find it in the catalog, but you know that it's a Fenton hobnail. You know the what? Okay, so is it marked Fenton? That's the first question.
It is on the bottom.
Okay, so do you know it's not a fake?
Well, based on the mark, I'm not an expert in, the mark itself, from what I can recognize.
I'm giggling at you because you're all like, oh gosh, I never even thought of that, And
it's possible.
I just want you to be aware of some of those types of things. So yes, it is marked. Yes, it does look like it's an authentic piece, but you've got to make sure that you're thinking about that because lots of things are copied, and actually reproduced. So be aware of that. It's a nice piece. Is it 18 inches? Is it 20 inches? How tall?
It's 20 and a half inches tall, exactly.
Okay. How did you acquire it?
I found it at a thrift store called Desert Industries about a month ago, and I paid about $3 for it.
Oh, wow. $3 is great.
Right?
Yeah, that's super. That's super. Yeah, it's a beautiful vase. I agree with Jackie. It's beautiful. Here's why. The color as well as the form. The form is really quite fine. It's very much of the 1960s. You can see it because not only of the bulbous bottom, but also of when that point comes up. Mm-hmm. When you get into the later part of the 60s, you're going to see that point be a little bit lower, and then basically they get really elongated like a taffy pole in the 1970s. Mm-hmm. So I want you to look for those types of things because I want you to be aware of that with respect to me. Hey, who's this? She's holding a piece right here, a framed piece. What's your name, hon?
Oh my gosh, I'm Terry. Hi, Dr. Lori.
Hi, Terry. How are you, babe? Where are you calling from?
I'm excited to talk to you.
Where are you calling from?
I'm in Dillon, Florida.
Okay, so you're in Florida. Would you buy this Fenton piece?
I like the color.
Yeah, I like the color too. So
I would buy it, sure.
Okay, sure. So your piece looks like a bas relief. It looks like it's somewhat almost 3D. It's like 2D, like a bas relief, right?
It is. I don't know what it is. I just bought it at the thrift shop the other day.
I like it. Is it signed?
It is.
All right. Who's it signed by?
M-A-G-I.
I like the Fenton piece better, but go ahead. What?
M-A-G-I. Maggi?
Oh, Maggi, like Magi. Yeah. Okay. Can I see the back quick? All right. Okay. I'll go 65 on that piece in Florida. I'll go 65 on this piece for the Fenton piece. I think you might get 75 on the Fenton, but 65 is a nice conservative appraisal for
that
piece.
Fabulous.
That's fabulous. You're happy with that. I'm happy with the color. I like the form. And the bas relief piece, and the reason why that one was brought in is so you get a sense, again, of that three-dimensionality, two-dimensionality. Show it right up to that. Who's this handsome guy in the coral shirt?
How you doing, Dr. Lori?
How you doing? What's your name?
Herbie.
Hi, Herbie. Did you get to Florida by way of I-95 from New York?
No, I got to Florida by way of my Cuban parents to Miami.
Oh, you're Cuban. You went the other way. You came north to Florida. I got it. Nice to see you there, Herbie. Good to see you guys. Thanks for being with me. Don't forget the frames have value. And when you look at those pieces, how much did you pay for that piece in the frame?
$2.
$2 is great for 65. I like it. $2 for 65 is very good too. $3 for 65 for the glass is good too. Before you girls go, don't go anywhere. I want to know, are you signed up for the newsletter?
Yes.
All right. I want to know, have you had a video call with me?
Yes.
I'm scheduled.
All right. Well, yeah, I went scheduled. That's what I like to hear. And also I want to know question of the day. Ready?
Bring it on.
You're both going to laugh at me because you probably aren't even doing this. Gloves or mittens? Which do you use?
Gloves.
You're in Florida.
Gloves.
gloves. I'm in Arizona, so
when I touch my artwork.
All right, so gloves when you touch the artwork. Gloves in Arizona. I like mittens. Nice to see you.
All right, thank you.
All right, Davies. See you. Oh, that was fun. But again, a couple of things you want to look for. So frames are going to tell you about value, and I've taught you that before. And I also want to make sure that when you're looking at these marks, like the Fenton mark, for example, bigger is always better. But when you're looking for the Fenton mark, make sure that that is an authentic Fenton mark. A lot of these pieces are reproduced and or faked. So I want you to make sure that you see that. Let's see where we are. Super chats and super stickers are a big way that you support my staff and you support, of course, what we're doing here to create more videos that will help you succeed, because that's what I want to do. And I can help you succeed because I know all this information. These other people who say they want to help you succeed can't really help you succeed. I want to make sure that you know what's what, right? That's what we want to do. So thank you very much for the buy the jewelry, best advice. That's good advice. I know I've been given all good advice, but I'm happy to, because I want you all to be successful in what you do. Anyway, guests are here from all over the place, and it's so much fun to bring them in. And hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good. Your first name is Joanne?
It is. Joanne from Maryland.
Hi, Joanne. So tell me, what is this and why did you acquire it? And why am I looking at it? Not very pretty.
Well, it's a piece of, I assume it's folk art. Let me hold it back. It's about 36 inches high. I bought it in 1968.
Okay, it's not a good piece of folk art, okay? Nothing against it, but it's not a good piece of folk art, which is why I'm making faces, because, you know, I don't play poker, people. Everything's right on my face. I can't play poker.
That's what we count on.
That's right. It's what a lot of people count on. That's true.
Yeah.
Okay. So you bought it in the late 60s. You've had it for a long time. Turn it around. Can I see? It's wood. It's polychromed wood.
Wood. Yes. And it's signed on the back, W. Right. McHugh. And
I like that better.
I looked up W. McHugh. Apparently there was a Warren McHugh who was a craftsman in Sag Harbor.
Right.
So I assume he died in 1986, I think.
But for those of you, very good. And for those of you who don't know about Sag Harbor, Sag Harbor is a great artist enclave. So that's an important point. And McHugh is relatively well known. So I like it better now that it's signed, but I didn't like it initially. And I didn't like it initially because of this. Proportion is off. Okay. Yep. Proportion is off. The head's kind of big. The arms are too long. And it's not, folk art is not supposed to be realistic per se. But again, I think a little bit of trying too hard. Signage and folk art go together very closely. Piece like this, you could see a 36-inch piece like this, you know, outside of maybe a jewelry store or maybe a craft place, that kind of thing. So McHugh is relatively well known. So I'm happy about that. So did you buy it in Sag Harbor? Or did you just buy it wherever you lived?
I bought it in New Jersey at a gift store in New Jersey.
Okay. And you've had it for a long time. And what's happening? Why did it come out of the closet now?
No, out of the closet. It has been hanging on my wall. There's another one there that I bought at the same time. It's been hanging on my wall continuously. No matter where I live, they hang. I love these pieces.
Okay, so it was never in storage. It was always out.
It's always on my wall.
Which is very important for its condition. Its condition is very good. And of course, you've also been able to maintain the signature. Show us the signature on the back. Oftentimes, carved sculptures like this will have a very simplistic signature like this. It'll have a title, maybe it'll have a date, and it'll have a signature on it. Oftentimes, that's what we see in folk art pieces. You'll see some kind of indicator of time, date, and origin. That's artist, title, and of course, date. That's oftentimes pretty typical. When I say it's polychromed wood, that's just fancy term for many colors on the wood, or much pigment of different colors on the wood. The face is nice. If you can tilt it down a little bit, yeah, that's cool. I would say value on that piece, $750. Do you remember what you paid?
$7.50.
There you go. 10%, I like it. That's very beautiful.
In 1968, that was a lot of money for me.
I'm sure $7.50, which is 1% of what it's worth, is a lot of money. That's true. But it's really quite beautiful. And he made a name for himself in these particular types of pieces. So I'm glad you got one. I'm glad that you enjoy it in your home. When I said out of the closet, I just meant I thought it was stored because it's big, you know?
No, I've been hanging it on the wall continuously for like 53 years. I love it.
Yeah, I like it. Well, it's cool. It's really cool. It's good that you're doing well. Mittens or gloves for the question of the day?
Totally mittens. Nice, thick woolen mittens.
Nice, thick woolen mittens. I don't care if I can't do my phone.
Same here. Right? Same
I don't care. I have the gloves that do that, that let me do the phone, but I like mittens, nice and warm. Well, I'm in New England, so I'm from New England. I'm used to that. And I know we've had a video call together. Did it work out for you?
It worked out beautifully for me. Great. Beautifully.
Great. Glad to hear it. Keep on thrifting. Find those treasures.
You bet.
All right. See you, Joanne.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Good to see her. And again, folk art, some of the things you want to look for. The polychrome wood is one of the things you want to look for. Of course, multicolors is one of the things you want to look for as well. But that signature, that title, that date, that's always nice to have on the back too. That'll pump up that value. Let's see what we've got. An exciting night. A lot of fun here, right? We've got a bracelet. We've got a ring. We've got a nice, what looks like a cast metal sculpture. Let's go with the ring. Got a blue shirt and a blue stone. Let's see what we've got. Hi, Ian.
Hi, Dr. Lori. Good. It's going well. I'm kind of having a bit of an audio issue right now. Everything is slow motion. You're in slow motion for me. Like, just audio. So I'm like,
audio is slow motion.
Okay. Slow, yes.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you slowly, but yes.
Okay. Well, it looks like you've got a sapphire and white gold and diamond ring. Is that what I'm looking at?
Sapphire and diamond. Yeah. Okay, and white gold, 14 karat.
14 karat white gold. So did you buy this online? Because I don't know if you all know Ian, but Ian buys a lot of jewelry online. He likes rings and he wears them and he enjoys them and he collects them. And so this piece, what did you pay for this piece? 100, 180? What'd you pay?
I just got this tonight as a present, actually. And we paid $450 for it. I was there, but it was $450. And yeah, it's just, I really like the coffin cut diamonds on it.
Okay. So a couple of things about it. First of all, typically you see these pieces in that $200 to $500 range, right? So what do you know about the sapphire?
Sorry, what?
That's okay. What do you know about the stone? Did you test the stone with the Presidium gem tester?
Oh, yeah. Yep. It's been tested on the Presidium, of course. Yep. As soon as I got home, I tested it. And it's, diamond and sapphire. Yep.
So everything's good. I like the color of the sapphire. Now, if you show us the sapphire for me, the front of it, a couple of things you're going to see. Different types of sapphires will have a little bit different color. The color matters, right? The value of the stone will matter as well. The size will matter, as well as the design of the, of course, overall ring. People forget about that, right? So the inexpensive rings that don't have a lot of design in the actual ring, right? That means maybe they don't have any kind of baguettes or any kind of diamonds on the side, or maybe they don't allow for some of the metal to be part of the design. So if it's just a straight, we just plunked or prong a ring in a setting and we put it on and that's it. We plunked a stone into a setting and that's the end of it. Usually those design pieces are not as high quality or high value. His is high value because not only is the color of the stone deep, dark, beautiful, but for of course the sapphire, but also you have nice design and diversity in the design with the diamonds and with, of course, the 14 karat gold. I like it, and I like it to the tune of about $800. It's a beautiful ring. Retail values based on actual sales records for that piece, about $800. So you're doubling your money.
So I did good on this one then, I think.
I think you did very well on that one, but I know that you typically only pay about $180, about $200. But again, this was a gift for a special occasion. Can I ask you what the special occasion was, or was it just because somebody loves you?
Just because I saw it and I really like it.
Okay, you're a spoiled boy. You're a spoiled boy, Ian. I know it. A lot of us are spoiled. We should all be spoiled, right? Well, it's nice to see you. Hey, are you using the binge link to binge all of my videos so you can get the most current ones first? Are you using the binge link?
Always, yes. I'm always refreshing myself on everything to do with Dr. Lori. Oh, yes.
I appreciate that.
Anytime I have something that I think I need to learn about or something new, I know that you've covered it. So
I appreciate that. I do cover it. I've got a lot of videos there. The binge link's easy to find at drlaurieb.com. Go to the specials and shop page. Click on it. It's red. It says specials and shop. You can't miss it. Go down and it says binge link. Copy the link and save the link. And that specials and shop page is also where you're going to go if you want to be part of Ask Dr. Laurie Live. That specials and shop page at the bottom of it is where we have the link so you can participate in my live stream. That's all the way at the bottom of the of that page. That page is chock full of good stuff. It's also where we put our discounts when we run specials. Hey, Ian, let me see those rings.
Oh, okay. Hang on.
Okay, hang on. Oh, nice. You got a good collection going there, hon. Wear them in good health. Nice to see you. Oh, question of the day. Gloves or mittens in Canada, Ian?
It's cutting out again. I can't hear. Is there
gloves
something
and mittens
up?
In Canada? Gloves or mittens in Canada? Question of the day.
I think I hear something about mittens.
Yes, is it
I'm
gloves?
I'm gonna choose mittens. I'll okay, choose mittens because I'm a mittens person.
All right, I like you. See ya. Poor guy. He can't hear. He can't hear. Well, he tried. I like you to see the jewelry and I like you to see complexity of design. When you see more design in a ring, and we're only talking about rings here, you know, you're going to see higher value. Gemstones are always going to be good as long as they are actual gemstones. You got to get the Presidium Gem Tester. And my other products, of course, are available through my website at drlaurieb.com. I get compensation when you buy something through the website. You help support, of course, the channel and what we're doing for all of you. All kinds of products that I like, that I recommend for years and years of my experience. I recommend the products that I use, that I like. So there you go. Oh, I'm going to yell at your boyfriend. Is it Rachel or Raquel? Let me tell you why. I'm not going to yell, really. But I really want you to think about it, because if you watch my Real Bargains videos, people are leaving very valuable pieces at the thrift store and they are flipping them for resale. Put him in front of my Real Bargains videos on the binge link and make him watch, you know, $20,000, $15,000, $1,200, the money that people are actually leaving on the floor, if you will, at the thrift store. Yeah, I will yell at him a little bit because he can find stuff that's cool for him too. Come on. It's there at the yard sale, the thrift store, grandma's attic. Look around. My guests are here. Let's see what they've got. Okay. Tar. That's a lot of bling. A lot of bling. Looks like a cross, a lot of bling. There's a lot of problems with the book because the cover really is damaged. So you see a lot of damage. I'm sorry, sweetheart. You're a cutie pie, but it's damaged. Let's see the book quickly, and then I think I'm going to talk about some jewelry. Well, let's look at this book. Hi, what's your name, hon?
Hi, my name is Courtney. I'm from Oregon.
Hey, Courtney. So Crime and Punishment, how old is it? Like, do you have a publication date on it? Because the front of it, I love books. I love books. But the front of it's kind of, it's been in some water. It's a little damaged.
I think it's a first edition.
Do you really?
Yeah, I would love.
In the space? I don't think it's a first edition, but go ahead.
We've got this signed. I'm very confused about it.
Let's not be confused. First of all, the front cover has damage, so that's going to decrease value. But okay, we've talked about that. The spine is not strong. Show me the spine, Courtney.
Sure.
Then I'll tell you where to go. The spine is not strong because it's moving, okay? Intact.
It was a library book.
Also decreases value. Next thing, you opened up that page and you said, I think it's signed under the engraved image of the author, right?
Sure. Would you like to
see
that?
Okay, I think that's print signed. That means it's signed in the print.
Yes.
Okay, so that's not as valuable as if they actually pen signed it or pencil signed it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, show me the title page if you would, hon.
Okay.
I like your cap. I was just on a podcast and my interviewer was wearing a cap and I said, I want a cap like that. You're going to send me a cap? I love that. All right. Let me see this. All right. What date is it?
The date on it is, I honestly, I have been having a hard time finding. I think it's 1860 something.
There's the late 1800s? Value for the first edition of Crime and Punishment is going to be just about $3,000. Value on your edition? Yeah, that's a library edition. A book club edition is what they usually call it. Value on that edition is going to be just about $200.
Okay.
Still not bad. How'd you get it, sweetie?
I found it at my local thrift store.
And that's based on actual sales records where similar pieces have sold. How much did you pay at the thrift store?
I paid $400 for it.
You paid $400 for it?
They say it's a first edition when I bought it.
Okay. Well, it's in pretty poor shape. So if we can identify that as the first edition, it's in pretty poor shape. I think you might have paid too much, darling. What's the best thing you like about the channel? Why do you watch my videos?
I love your energy and I love how informative you are when you are actually appraising an item. I learn a lot really fast.
Really fast. We want to go really fast. It's nice to meet you, honey. Keep it up. A book collection is always a good collection to, of course, build. And if you find more information that you want to give me about that, once you look at it some more and find the date and such, you can always send that to drlaurieV.com, you know, my form, my contact form. You can do that.
Okay.
I'll take a look for you and help you out. Anyway, before you go, gloves or mittens in Oregon?
Oh, it's mittens all the way.
Mittens all the way. I like your glasses too. Thanks, Courtney.
Thank you.
All right. Courtney is a bookworm, so she likes books. And that one's nice, but the condition was very, very poor. The condition was poor. Once you see that spine start to go, then you have to get into the idea of rebinding things, and that can be very costly. So she might have paid too much on that. But you live and learn. That's okay. Lori, thank you for always supporting the channel. There's some of you who always support the channel. Whatever way you do it, I'm happy that you do it. Whether it's a super sticker, whether you're sharing, whether you're watching. I want to know where you're actually watching from. So in those comments, please tell me where you're watching from. I'm saying hi from here. I like mittens. I want gloves, whatever it might be. And my guests, of course, are always here and they make it just as much fun. Let's see what we've got. I want to look at the blue necklace. Can I look at the blue necklace?
This one?
Yeah, it's a blue necklace. Is it blue? Is it purple? What is it, honey?
Hi, Dr. Lori. It's Mary calling from Canada.
Hi, Mary. Is this blue? Is this purple? It's purple.
It's purple. It's purple. So purple crystals.
Nice. German.
Yeah, it's 22 inches long. There are real pearls. I did your test.
Good. So the real pearls with the crystals. That's possible. That's very possible, actually. How about the lighter lavender color stones?
Okay, so I think those are amethysts. I don't have a gem tester yet, but to me, they're definitely stone. There are three of them.
They're very big.
And they look like amethysts. I'm quite sure they are. And then the flowers are abalone.
That's nice. Is it marked?
No, it's not. And I paid $8 for it at the thrift store.
Wow, excellent.
And I absolutely love it. My birthstone is February, is amethyst. So I'm drawn to purple things.
Right. Well, purple is the color of royalty, you know.
There you go.
So, you know, that's a very nice piece. I'll say a couple of things that I like about it. They do look like amethyst. They look like they're lower quality amethyst, but they're quite large. Okay.
Yeah.
The other thing about it, you did test that they were pearls. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
The crystals are definitely German because you're seeing how they're catching the light. Yeah. Very high quality German crystals in the purple. There's a lot of them. These are the things that you look for. Yeah. Is it continuous or does it have a clasp?
It has a magnetic clasp.
I don't know if
that tells you anything, but.
Oh, that tells me that it probably was restrung at one point.
Okay.
So that probably I'm sorry, honey.
So I was just going to say that makes sense because the top part, these are all knotted in between and they're on like a string and these are wired at the bottom. Yeah.
Well, there's a couple things happening. If you have it where there's it's knotted on string, maybe it's silk, maybe it's just a thread, you want to look for that. If you see wires, that's because they're trying to deal with the weight. You know, they're doing so much in the weight. And usually the wires are actually woven almost like crochet to basically catch everything, right?
They are woven.
They're thin wires, but they'll support all of this weight of a statement necklace. And these terms are going to be important if you're a reseller and you want to list these pieces, right? A great statement necklace. I like this piece very much. Mainly, I like it, not even for the amethyst, not even for the pearls. Sure, those are icing on the cake. I like the German crystals because they're good quality and there's a lot of them. For $8, that piece is worth $400.
Woo!
Beautiful. beautiful piece of costume jewelry. So, you know, the boyfriends were saying you can't get anything for costume jewelry. Look at the markets and see what's what. And remember, I don't have a dog in the hunt. I'm not making a price guide and then buying and selling the items. I'm here to help you. If you're going to appraise pieces and evaluate the market with respect to value, you can't be involved in buying and selling it. And that has been my mission and my mantra for nearly 25 years. The people who are saying, I'll appraise it for you and then I want to make you an offer are not appraisers. So be clear on that. That piece is really quite fine. I think that's beautiful. Well, do you wear it? Will you wear it for your birthday since your birthday's coming up?
You know what? I will. I will wear it for my birthday.
I would too. I would too. Everything looks good with a black dress. Gloves or mittens for you, sweetie?
Well, you got to wear mittens in Canada. Gloves don't keep you warm enough.
Got to be warm enough. Congratulations. As I say on my videos, that's a real bargain.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Yay. That's a nice one. That's a nice one. But that's one of the things you want to look for. You want to look for that diversity of you having the silk or the thread, right? That's actually woven, holding up the crystals, and then the wire. The wire is going to support a little bit more weight, and you don't want to lose any of that stuff. So that's what we actually see. So I always thank you for respecting my staff. So those of you who say thanks to the staff, I love to see that because my staff works hard. They work very hard because you all go, oh, Dr. Laura, you work so hard. And they run just as fast as I do. So I appreciate you guys realizing that they're doing a lot to help you. My guests are here. Let's see who we got. I want to look at the Wedgwood, but she is not horizontal. So I need her to put her camera horizontal. I'd like to look at the Wedgwood because I know a lot of you have Wedgwood. When she figures out how to get her camera not horizontal, it might be locked. In the meantime, let's look at this. Let's look at this casting. Let's look at this cast figure of this animal. Because a lot of you have sculpture. Hi, how are you?
Good. Hi, Dr. Lori.
Hi, what's your name?
Barb.
Hi, Barb. Nice to see you. What have you got? Can you back up on this piece? There you go.
I got it in an estate sale a few years ago, and I really haven't been able to find out much about it. It's stamped D period, L period, and it's 72 of 5,000.
Okay.
Real heavy, and I'm not even sure what material.
Okay. Show us the bottom, and I'll tell you about material. All right. So it's patinated and cast bronze. There's 5,000 of them out there. They probably were made for fundraising of a public sculpture. So you're saying, well, what does that mean? Here's what happens. You get a sculpture that's relatively small. And the idea is that you sell the small ones and you usually make a addition number of 2,500 or 5,000. And the artist is trying to raise funds so he can pay for the big sculpture or a big project, right, for his work. So they sell the small ones because people will say, oh, I'll spend $750 or $500 on a small one, right? Because then I'll be part of actually supporting or funding the large sculpture. That's usually a sculpture within an actual town or city or something like that. That's bronze and it's cast and it's patinated and it's very nicely done. It's signed and it's a limited edition. Now you're saying, gosh, Lori, 5,000 is not that limited. No, but they're trying to raise money, right? So that's typically what you're looking at. How much did you pay for it?
$10.
You paid $10 for it? Did you buy it at the thrift store?
I bought it in an estate sale.
What drew it to you at the estate sale? Why did you?
I don't know. I kept looking at it and it was so smooth when I picked it up and just cuteness. I don't know.
One of the things, so it was just attractive to you. Right. Is it heavy? It should
be very heavy. Very heavy.
It's very heavy because it's bronze. And that's one of the things I want you to look for. If you pick up a sculpture like that in that coloration, right? So sort of that browny, golden, you know, kind of greenish color. And if you pick it up, 99 times out of 100, it's going to be bronze. If it has an edition number, it might be a low edition, one of 12, or a very big edition like she has, like Barb has, which is big because they're trying to usually do that as a fundraiser. They get a lot of them out there and then they try to sell each ones individually. When I was the project art historian on the National Irish Memorial Monument in Philadelphia, they sold little maquettes of one of the figures from that monument. And the idea was, of course, to raise money so the big monument that's at Penn's Landing could actually be erected. So it costs a lot of money for those sculptures to be erected. Back to you. Value on yours, about $750. So for your $10 investment, two thumbs up. Why? Because you got fine art. I always tell you, look for fine art, furniture, precious metals, including jewelry. You won't go wrong. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
My pleasure. My pleasure. Now tell me, have you had a gift certificate from us?
I just started. I got my computer for Christmas and I just came into like last 2 weeks and I've been watching y'all night.
Well,
I'm looking to get you some stuff.
Use the binge link and hint to those who love you that you need a gift certificate for some occasion.
All right.
And before you go, my question of the day is mittens or do you use gloves? Do you prefer gloves or mittens?
Gloves.
Gloves. Okay, gloves. Well, you can do more with your hands with gloves.
Right.
I have the thing about mittens because I always wear I don't really wear a hat much. I like hats, but I don't wear them much. I wear sort of, it's like a big hairband that basically.
Me too. The headbands, yeah.
I like the headbands that keep your ears warm because I got a lot of hair, so my neck is already warm. But I like to keep my ears warm. Nice to meet you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful work of art.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Very nice. So you're looking at good materials like bronze. You're looking at, of course, a nice figural form. Really good. I like that piece a lot. We've got some cool pieces here tonight. We've got some cool pieces here. My guests are here. Let's see what we've got. Hey, we still don't have the I thought the wedgie was going to be ready. So the wedgie is still not ready. Let's see.
There's a chance.
Dr. Lori said you're wearing the t-shirt. How many of you have the mug or the t-shirt? I want to go with the t-shirt.
She's looking at my t-shirt.
I'm looking at your t-shirt. Hi, how are you? Thank you for supporting the channel with the Dr. Lori Says t-shirt. It looks
good. Absolutely.
What's your name?
My name's Debbie from San Diego.
Hi, Debbie. You know, you've got an amphora there. It's a pretty nice vase, and it looks like it's textural glass.
It is.
Very nice. Is it marked?
The sticker came off of it, but it says a bunch of stuff that's not in English, but the last word is Murano.
Okay, so what are the other words before you get to Murano?
Okay, questo articolo e stato idio de un maestro di Murano.
Okay, so your Italian is not your first language,
right?
Right,
I know.
No, I'm joking with you. What should you do? Go to Google Translate and type the stuff in so you can see what it says. That's one of the things a lot of you should do, right? That's a great tip, easy, right? I'm glad you love the t-shirts. I love it and I appreciate you doing that with the mugs and the t-shirts and the whole thing. So this thing is an amphora form. You'll notice it's on a stand, right?
Yes.
So that idea was trying to look back at the ancient Greeks and ancient Romans that used these forms, usually in clay and not in glass, but usually use these particular forms for storage. So that's what it would be used for all the way back to, you know, the first century AD with the Romans. Your piece, of course, dates to the middle part of the 1900s, and it's very beautiful and very big, and I love that you've got the sticker. Like that you have the Murano sticker. How did you acquire it? Did the stand come with it?
It did.
How much did you pay?
How much did we pay? It was at a furniture store like in the 70s when we bought some furniture. It was on display.
So you've had it a long time in your home?
Yes.
Okay. So it's on display in the furniture store and you bought that too. Did you buy two of them or just one?
Just one.
Okay. Do you remember what you paid?
Do you know what we paid? You know what? I'm sorry. I don't.
That's okay. That's fine. But let's assume that you probably couldn't have paid too much for it because it's the 1970s and they're trying to sell the furniture along with accessories.
Right.
So it's hand blown, of course. It's hand blown in Murano. That's Venice, of course, Venice, Italy, and the great. And you can't put the Murano sticker on it unless, of course, it was done in the furnaces at Murano. So that's important. So you got the real deal. These are imported in by many different import companies that would import all kinds of stuff in from Europe in the 60s and 70s to the United States.
Okay.
How tall is it?
It is probably 20 inches.
20 inches tall. I would say value on the piece today, about $250 includes the stand.
Wonderful. Thank you, Dr. Lori.
Hey, it's certainly my pleasure. It's nice to meet you. I'm going to ask you, even though you're in California, mittens or gloves?
Probably gloves.
Probably gloves.
Yeah.
Nice to see you. Don't forget to, of course, keep watching and keep sharing. You got to share the channel. That's what you got to do on your social media channels, on all of your pages, with your friends and family, through word of mouth. You got to share the channel, and you got to subscribe on YouTube too. I'll see you next time.